Now, first off, development economist with the University of Ghana, Dr. Eric Essay Esibe, is asking government not to heed calls for the Heritage Fund to be used to mitigate the challenges currently confronting the economy. He says government should rather put in place pragmatic and innovative policies towards revenue generation while it leaves the fund for the well-being of future generations.
The Heritage Fund is a strategic endowment reserve set up to support development for future generations when Ghana's petroleum reserves have been depleted, according to the Petroleum Revenue Management Act of 2011. The fund receives 9% of the country's annual petroleum revenue. However, there have been calls for the fund to be used to assuage the country's economic woes. But development economist Dr. Eric Osei Esibe says it is not an ideal thing to do.
Petroleum is a non-renewable natural resource. So over a period of time, it is no longer going to be there. You know, we are going to deplete it, which means that the future generation will not have the opportunity to benefit from it. And therefore, if we do not set something apart for the future generation, it means that we are only trying to satisfy our present need without thinking about the future generation. When is it appropriate to touch it? I think when it comes to a point where we have realized that we have met our present needs and we need to put something or do something for the benefit of the future generation. For example, if you are thinking into the future, maybe thinking about building a railway line that is going to last for the next 100 years or something like that, which is to the benefit of the future generation, which could be understandable, right? But even that one, the future still needs some kind of buffer, you know, that they can also fall on in the event that they do not come to meet oil.
He indicates the use of the fund will not make any significant difference, and hence the need for government to find innovative ways of generating revenue.
It's putting in place appropriate policy measures, you know, being more pragmatic with our policies, coming up with clear policy guidelines that will help, particularly in terms of revenue generation. Because if you look at our tax revenue today, it's woefully inadequate. It's just about 17%, less than 17%. Whereas if you compare ourselves to the emerging economies like Brazil, is about 35% of GDP. Ours is not even up to 20%. Okay, so the government has to find a very innovative way of generating revenue. That is what should engage our minds now, because the problem that we are having is not too much about the expenditure. It's about the fact that our revenues are not enough, because we are developing countries and we need to spend to expand the economy. That is provided we spend on productive sectors of the economy.
Dr. Sesibe Mihol says the stabilization fund, into which 21% of annual oil revenues are paid, if still available, could support the economy in dire times. Abigail Adumakunchi for Joy News.
Well, the debate goes on, but the onus lies on government to decide. Well, away from that, Minister of Trade and Industry Haruna Idrisu has tasked a newly inaugurated board of the Ghana Trade Fair Center to develop the center into an international trade, convention and exhibition center with recreational facilities, shopping mall, real estate and hotels, among others. He says government is ready to partner a lead investor from Dubai to develop the center at a cost of about $2 billion.
Minister Haruna Idrisu swore into office a 9-member board to steer the affairs of the Ghana Trade Fair Company Limited, the trade fair center noted for exhibitions and trade shows of locally made goods, according to the trade ministry, remains challenged and underdeveloped. Speaking to Joy News in an interview after the inaugural ceremony, Trade Minister Haruna Idrisu tasked the new board to assist government and take advantage of the 127-acre land, as well as its proximity to the sea, to develop the center into a standard national trade center.
For the trade fair to continue to play its role in promoting trade, promoting made in Ghana good, we are reaching out at a government-to-government level and public-to-private sector intervention and investment in the trade fair. We should have an international trade convention center with a shopping mall, real estate, recreational centers, the International Convention Center, which should be a sine qua non to any development of the 127 acres of land. You can have supporting hotels, which will become, when you check in, you check in for both hotel and for the opportunity to be at the conference center. So it will be an in-house facility which has hotels attached to the International Trade Convention Center.
He explained government was working on the project's funding.
We have had major expression of interest from four, five major reputable international companies. There is one which is at government-to-government level with the government of Dubai, a major real estate which has shown interest. I will forward their proposal to the new board for them to advise on what relationship we can nurture with that investor. Government will be equity, but we are expecting $1 to $2 billion investment in the trade fair, which will be largely led by the partner, an investor who partner government and the people of La for the development of the trade fair into a modern trade and exhibition center. I also challenge the board to ensure financial discipline and financial prudence in the management of the assets and resources of trade fair.
He also called on the board to appropriately manage retiring benefits and clean up the existing issues on financial malfeasance in the company. Chair of the board, Hannah Mwating, noted the board's readiness to work efficiently.
On behalf of the board, I wish to say that we will work diligently with the executive management of the trade fair company to make sure that our current mandate of turning the trade fair company and its assets into an international fair center to be reckoned with, we would work diligently to make sure this is executed. And we will also work to ensure that the management structure is clearly defined, as you have put across.
And corporate organizations have been advised not to focus too much on profits, but also find the need to give back to society by performing their corporate social responsibility. The AJI President James Asari Ejay, who made a call, says businesses must strive to be socially friendly despite the harsh economic conditions.
The Ghana CSR Diary and Awards is an annual program aimed at identifying and celebrating organizations which are socially responsible as role models. Nestle Ghana, Huawei Technology, Olam Ghana, Melcom, Golden Sunbeam School, Fan Milk and Well Weaving Industries were among the companies that walked away with laurels. With only about 16 awardees, organizers were optimistic of expanding the scope next year.
We are going bigger. Next year, hopefully, we might go West African. We might, you know, include other countries. And also in terms, we're creating the awareness gradually. And through the efforts of the Ghana CSR Diary and Award and other stakeholders and other activists, now we are seeing a situation where the Ministry of Trade and Industry is considering a CSR policy for industry in Ghana. In the past, people, I mean, a lot of business people used to think that CSR ended with ordinary donation to orphanages and to the needy. But now they are beginning to understand that CSR should be an integral part of the award scheme itself. We might introduce categories of CSR award. In future, we would incorporate all these international best practices and make the award bigger.
The AGR president at the awards night said, the AGI is instrumental in ensuring best business practice, training and capacity building of its members.
We were very instrumental in the Ghana Companies Business Code, I mean, which actually enjoins, I mean, businesses to ensure good business practices. We have also through, I mean, the promulgation or bringing into place of that Ghana Business Code, also got involved in the UN Global Compact, you know, which we signed. I mean, these are all activities, you know, that goes to attest, you know, goes to attest to the fact that, yes, we are also supporting businesses. Government has been engaging, and we believe that that the level of engagement should go on. If there's any policy direction for which government can appeal, I mean, can actually give, I mean, the kind of concise direction to businesses to contribute more as far as corporate social responsibilities are concerned, please, it's welcome.
He added that CSR is critical for an organization's success and its corporate image and sustenance. Despite the macroeconomic constraints, the AGR president, James Asariejei, advised businesses to make the activities environmentally and socially friendly to enhance their activities beyond profit.
You operate in a society, in a community. There's always the need that you appreciate contribution of society, and for that matter, you also give back to society. And in most cases, one way of doing that is really through corporate social responsibility activities. Whether you are drilling boreholes to the for the community, whether you are building schools, whether you are supporting, you know, in any form that will help alleviate the situation of whatever people or community you find yourself in, I mean, it is good. And I believe that that is the way that businesses should look at issues related to CSR.
The AGI is meanwhile collaborating with Ghana CSR on criteria, as well as information on organizations' best corporate practices.